Hey folks, it's Frithgar here. How you doing? We did a bit more work in the end, and then we've come back because there's a whole load of things that we need to get. So first of all, let's have some breakfast out onto the balcony. And today I'm going to go out this side and take a look over the nature side, the nature reserve. And that's what we're going to turn this into. I've said about having a jungle corner. We're going to plant a whole load of jungle trees and sort of turn one part into a jungle piece. And yeah, I don't know what you think, Sen. Sort of try and convert this into several separate biomes just in this area down here. See if we can sort of represent each of the biomes down there. What do you think?
No, I think that's a good idea.
See if we can try that. Might be difficult to do the snowy ones, but anyway, yeah. So, let's have some breakfast. Oh, that's so tasty. Oh, I really do like rabbit. I really like rabbit. I never thought I'd enjoy a food so much. Anyway, we have work to do. Sen is going to run over to the slime farm, and she's going to get me a couple stacks of slime balls, because I need them. I also need some stone. I've got some cooking downstairs, and I'll just take that end stone, because we will be needing that. I need a whole load of redstone. Let's take a couple stacks. Actually, I want another three or four stacks. I need some repeaters, and I need torches, so let's get a few more because I need to make some more torches. A couple stacks of sticks. I'm slowly filling up with loads of stuff here. Right, so if I take a stack of sticks, stack of redstone, that gives me some redstone torches. I need to do the same again, like that. Right, so now I have all these redstone torches. Next thing I do is I put stone at the bottom like that. I put a piece of redstone in the middle, and then I put redstone torch outside. Redstone torch outside gives me a redstone repeater. There's 64 of them. I need to do that again, but I need some more stone. So let's pop down here, because I left a whole load of stone cooking. You can see all of these, they're cooking away quite nicely. What did I have in the first one? Oh yeah, I've got a couple bits of gold here, so we can pick these out and get the XP. How much have I got? I've got 32. Right, if I keep going round, I should actually have enough for my next three stacks I need. Another one. And another one. Right, there's three stacks of stone. And if I zip back up, we'll make the next lot. So again, we put them along the bottom like that. Oh, I don't know, I don't have enough. I need to make a couple more redstone torches. Sticks. Have I got any sticks left? Two more stacks of sticks. You use a lot of redstone. It's not so much a big redstone circuitry. All you need is a redstone repeater for each sort of section of this thing that we're going to build. And you'll see when we get there, because I'll show you one of them, and then we'll sort of carry on and build the rest, I think. Because otherwise it's just going to get dull. So if I take those, and I'll put those in the ender chest. We've used a load of stone slabs. We used masses of them. I've actually made a whole host more. We've been really busy. We have done a lot of work here since you've been gone. And you'll see what I mean. Is there anything else I need to change? No. Right, the next thing that we need is 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it's same again, so that makes two stacks. And 1, 2 for two stacks. What was the other one? Oh, I need more redstone dust. I got one stack. That makes two stacks. You have got no idea what I'm talking about at the moment. Sen, do you have any idea when I keep talking about stacks?
Nope, not a clue.
Well, don't worry. All will become obvious when I finish doing this. So let's make some more wood there like that. I imagine some people have already realised what I'm about to make with all this lot. I don't want a full stack. Let's take a half one of those. I am running out of space here. Right, that's all I can carry. That one's going to have to stay there like that just for a minute. And you put three pieces of wood. It doesn't actually matter. You can mix the wood if you want to. Then you put cobblestone down the side here, 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 and here like this. And I know I've showed everybody this before, but once again, that's how you do it. It does not matter what sort of wood you put up there. You can mix it, as you can see. That makes us a stack of pistons. So then I'll do the same again. I'll put three lots of acacia wood up there. Then cobblestones down the sides like that. A stack of iron in the middle, and then redstone underneath. Another stack of pistons. So that's all the pistons that we need. Have I got wood over here? I don't actually have any wood there. We used up some. Sen used up a fair bit. Sen, thank you. Can you stick the slime balls in that chest? Yes, that's right. Brilliant, thank you. Right, I want 2 stacks of those. Wow. That slime farm really does well, doesn't it?
I wasn't sure how many you wanted me to bring, so I just bought all of them.
I'm really pleased that we built that. That is doing really well. Right, so we need sticky pistons for this, so that requires a piston and a slime ball for each one. So there's 2 stacks of those. So I'll pop those in there like that. We're going to use this end stone. We're going to need a whole load more, which Sen will get. That's everything that we need here. Pistons. Oh, well, sticky pistons. Oh, no, there is one more thing. There's one more thing. And this is the one I can't actually remember how to make. Is it with... I'll soon find out. Is it cobblestone? No, it's stone. It's plain stone, I think. Let's take this stack of stone, and this will soon tell us. Right. That makes a button... That makes a stone pressure plate. Yeah, I need smooth stone. So, I got 32 stone pressure plates. I want to get another few stacks. So let's fish out what we got left in here. There we go. That one. Yeah. Oops. Yeah. Right. Oops, 55 in that one. Oh, yes, because I didn't actually pick up the others. Right, that's probably enough to keep us going, just so that you can see what we're going to be doing. So if I knock these together really quickly, 47 stone pressure plates there, and that will be another 60-odd. Right, well, that's actually more than we need, so just spread those out there, take the last ones. I'll put that stone back, and finally in there, put in those pressure plates. Right, is that everything that I need? Got a crafting table. I'll take out those glass bottles so we've got a little bit of room if I carry that one around. Okay, Sen, let's go to the end. There's nothing else you need, is there? We got everything?
No, I don't think so.
Right, okay.
I don't think we need anything.
I got 5 pearls left over from our last trip to the end. So let's try chucking a couple. These are so cool. I really do love them. I'm really looking forward to being able to play golf with these. It's going to be a lot of fun playing golf. Lob them up like that. Actually, landed right.
Oh, no!
Oh, I'm on top of a tree. What?
I'm getting attacked by something small and purple.
Oh, that's an endermite. Yeah, very occasionally when you launch one of these things, you get an endermite sort of spawn.
Thanks.
That's brilliant. Right. I'm not going to waste the rest of these for now. But it is going to be a lot of fun when we can play that game. Have you got another one there? Where are you going?
Oh, I was killing a rabbit for you.
Ooh, thank you. Did you get anything nice?
No.
Ah, okay, right. So, yeah, we're going to go to the end and get over to our farm. And Sen has been doing a load of mining. She was doing a load of mining just here, but she's going to go up there where we've got that glowstone put down now. Because, we're sort of perched on the edge of it here, and we didn't want to risk falling through, because that's just going to get messy. And the other thing is... I'm trying to be really careful I don't actually get knocked off the edge, because we know what happens with that. You gotta look right down at your feet, and yeah, there we go. If I get it just right, I can knock them off the edge when I hit them with a sword and then stare at their feet at the same time. So yeah, we got this. We built this platform out. We put a load of glowstone along, which you probably remember, and that's what we've done. That's what we've done. We've used all those half slabs. We had loads of them. And sort of gone all the way up so that the Endermen can't teleport through. They can't spawn on there anywhere. And when they're falling, they can't sort of be pushed through either. And that's the main idea, is that they can't get pushed through the sides. Or move through the sides. Right, I've got a few stone slabs in there. I'm going to drop some of this stuff in here so that it stays safe. And I'm also going to drink a night vision potion now. To light things up a bit. I got one glowstone. I'm going to need some up the top. I got some torches. That's all right. We'll just use torches. If I take that potion there, like that, swap that round. I didn't have another one. I left it in here. Yeah, there it is. Right, I'll take that one with me. Keep it up there. Right, I want the sticky pistons, stone pressure plates, redstone repeaters, and I need endstone. So let's go on up the top, and I'll show you what we've been up to. All of these are set exactly 2 blocks apart. So it's half slabs, and then that sort of on the top bit, I'll show you. If I just place one down here, there, you see, it's on the top, and got one above, and then you can't put one in there, because that's another half slab above, so you've got half slab spare. And then that one is exactly two. So always, we've got a gap of two in between. So it's the most efficient way of doing it, but the Endermen can't move through it because they need three blocks to move. So that can stay there, and now we climb up the side here to the very top. Hopefully there aren't too many Endermen up here. I think I can't remember if I left it light or dark up here. And we start work on the more difficult bit. There is one other thing that we're going to need to bring back, and that is some vines, because of the way that this whole system will work. But we won't worry about that at the moment. So what we're going to have to do is, first of all, let me just line up these things. I don't actually need those. I need the pressure plates, the repeaters, the end stone, and the sticky pistons. Now, you use end stone, don't use earth. You can use normal stone, because I believe Endermen don't pick up normal stone. Or you can use end stone, and we're just going to use end stone because that's what's here. Just makes the whole thing a bit easier. So you put a block down on the end like that, and then... Oh, Sen! We haven't done the word.
What word? Yeah.
What word? Lock?
Block.
Oh, block. Okay, that could be interesting. We are going to have to think of a penalty for the person that wins or loses. So we can't say the word that describes every single thing that is found in the world. Very good. Yes. Okay, so we put a sticky piston on top of the piece of endstone that we got just there. And we put another one just there like that. Then you put a repeater going into it down there, into the endstone item there. And then the endstone piece that's there, put another one in like that. You put a pressure plate in front. Now, what happens when you press on? You stand on the pressure plate, activates the sticky piston, and that is rather crucial to this whole thing, because when an Enderman spawns, and this piece up here, this is also sort of kind of crucial because that's the next level up. You put that in front like that, and then when he spawns there, that will push him right off. I'm not actually going to stand there because I don't have any... Actually, yes, if I put those two there, it doesn't matter if I have suicidal, because that'll go there, and then it just shoves you back onto that one. So let's remove those two. We don't need them now. They can go. Down they go. Right, and yeah, when we built that, we should have left a place to get down through. So let's knock a hole through. Put a couple up, like that. Which way round do I want to go? That's going to make it a bit more difficult. Oh, hello, Sen. How are you doing?
Hi. I thought you might want some more stone.
We will do. Just a second. I'm trying to find a way to get up through here. Right, there we go. Okay, so I'm up here. This is the next level, and we're going to do this. Basically, we're going to carry on up. We're going to go up another five or six levels at least. So that you've got quite a lot of this contraption here, this sort of setup. Now that is two above the floor. It goes up two, and it actually will go up 3.5, because that's a half slab. That goes above that's the sort of a top half slab. Not the bottom half slab, it's like an upside down half slab is often called. The bit on the very top. What was that? You're sounding very weird over there. Anyway. So you've got a upside down half slab on the top, and that I very nearly backed off the edge there. Three of them, and then a half. So you got 3.5 blocks up. 3.5 pieces.
Already?
Up. Yeah, well, it's very difficult to explain this without being able to say that word. I think you're just mean, because you're not explaining it. I think that is just downright cruel. I think we're going to have you explain some of this.
I don't know what you're doing.
Yeah, so... That is the configuration that we need to construct, and we will do that all along the edges. And then when the Endermen drop, they drop the 42. Between each layer, what we're going to have to do is we're going to hang some vines along the edge so that they will fall down, and then the vines will slow down their fall, and then they'll carry on. And hopefully, if all works well, they will just then drop down to the bottom and we can kill them with one punch. We'll need to put some floating signs underneath the vine to stop it from growing all the way down and slowing everyone down. Hopefully that will work. We will have to test it later on. So we're going to carry on and start constructing these. Let me just remove those two. And we're also going to go up another few blocks. And Sen, well, you could probably start working on that again. Go up the next layer. We want to go up at least five layers. We're going to do this. So you can start working on the next layer of half slabs. And I'm going to start work on all the pistons that are going to need to go down the sides here.
Have a problem.
You have a problem?
Yeah.
What sort of problem?
I may or may not have left the half slabs at the house.
Oh, don't worry. I've got loads down in my ender chest down here. I'll just nip down and get them. Down really slowly. I'm very cautious about throwing myself off the edge here. I was thinking of getting a slime block or two and putting down here so we could just jump off. But I can just see myself bouncing right off the edge and falling into the endless void. Did I just say it again? I did. I said slime. But I said
slime. Yeah, you did.
Two. I am so bad at this. I really am. Right. There is a load of half slabs in the plain chest.
Oh, you're not putting them up. You haven't brought them up. All right, hang on.
Oh, well, I can bring them up if you want me to.
No, sorry, I'm coming down now. No, I'd have followed you if...
Ah, I see.
Sorry.
Maybe I could enderpearl up there. Although, the thing is, I don't know, if you throw an enderpearl out into the endless void, does it kill you? This is the question. Right, anyway, we're gonna carry on with this, and when we've made some progress, we'll give you an update. So far, I'm up onto the third layer, and I just thought I'd come back and show you a bit of the progress that we're up to. And I bring the sticky pistons down in a great big long line like this. I'm just running out now. I've put down all of those, and you'll see that I put a layer in between, and you'll see why in a minute, because it gets a bit sort of interesting when you're trying to put down different blocks and standing on all the pressure plates, because those are the bits that activate it all. And we also will need to go in between every layer in a minute anyway, because of the we got to put jungle vines down. We need to put vines along the edge, which will slow down the Enderman as they drop. So let's just put those up through there like that. We run a line of these up through. This bit's nice and easy, really quick. So there's those pressure plates. And then you take end stone, put over the tops like this. There. And then I'll show you. I'll walk along the edge of it a bit, and you'll see what I mean. We're still going to put a couple of torches in here because we don't want anything spawning in here yet. And then once we finish, when we get to the very end of it, then we will just start putting removing the torches as we move down through as we do the jungle vines. So let's put some of these up here. And there, see? Whenever an Enderman spawns, he can only spawn on the pressure plate. It's the only place that he can spawn. Pushes him out to the middle. There, see? He cannot go anywhere else. Pushes out to the middle, and then he drops. So, next I need to just fill in this gap up here. And I do it like that, and then run back through with a few of them, like so. Same on this side. Sen is going up and doing all of the floor up there. And then I'm going to come up like this. Put in those. There we go. Up another one. Right. That's those in, and then I'll start around on this side and just keep going. And I need to be kind of careful what I'm doing. I'm not going to have enough end stone for this next layer. I'm going to have to go and get a bit more. But we do have a ladder system that we've been building, sort of part of our scaffolding, as we've been working our way up, so that we can go and get more supplies when we need it. And so each layer, once I've made sure that I got enough, I can just leave one piece open there. Ready to go and get the next round of supplies. So the next thing I'll do, if I start dropping these pistons on here like this. How many layers are you up to there, Sen?
I'm doing the eighth one now.
Eighth one.
Yes,
we were... what did we say? We're going to have eight layers, aren't we?
Yeah.
I think it was eight. And
we were going to have seven, but then you thought we might as well...
Yeah, we might as well do one more. You can take this thing as high as you like. There is absolutely no limit apart from the build limit. And literally, With this one, the sky is the limit, and it is quite literally the case, because when you get to the top of the build limit, that's as far as you can go, and that's up in the sky. So the sky is the limit. I think that's quite funny. Kind of amusing, anyway. Mm. Yes? No? One day, I'm going to tell a joke that you're actually going to laugh at, Sen. You're actually going to find it funny. Yeah, one day. That is the dream. That's the dream. One day, I'll be able to tell a joke funny enough to make Sen laugh.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, that'd be more
like it. I don't have hope.
You just drop some half slabs, Sen. Don't worry, I'm picking up your rubbish for you.
Thank you.
And a couple of blocks here, and that's it. Yes. I'm not going to use a cobblestone. I don't think Endermen actually pick up cobblestone, but I want to use endstone on it anyway, because I think it's going to look better. Now, this is a bit you got to be careful on. You do have to have a head for heights when you're sort of climbing down this bit, because, yeah, it's a long way down. All of these rings, I did show you, I said to you before, they are all spaced exactly right so that we don't have any mishaps, and I don't actually have any more endstone here. Have you got any more up there, Sen?
Yeah, I've got loads.
Great, I came all the way down here and you've got the stuff up there. Right, what did I have? I had some more because I did actually go back home and make a few more bits and pieces.
Do you want me to bring it down?
No, I got to go back up now. Got to climb back up to the top. So yeah, I went back home while Sen carried on building the rings up the way up through, and I made a few more repeaters and pressure plates and so on because we didn't have enough to complete the build. So hopefully now I've got enough. I've got another stack of each. There you are. Right, up through.
I'm done.
You're finished, are you?
Yeah.
Let's just go to next layer up. Here we go. This one. You come in here, just ever so carefully, because you don't want to fall off the edge. Just inside here. If I could have the... Yeah, that's all right. If I could have the end stone, please.
Oh, yeah.
In your own time, yeah. No, you're not holding anyone up, really.
Hush up.
Right.
Right, what should I do?
Have you got any end stone left on you?
Yep.
Fill in those gaps there. Actually, yeah, you start filling in the gap here, up here like that, all the way back through. Leave a hole one space wide so that we can climb up through. I can now fill in this one. And if I just put in each of the items on here like this, there we go. And we're running out of time, and I was kind of hoping that we'd have this thing finished today, but I don't think we're going to. I think we're going to have to come back again tomorrow and have another go. What's going on here? Oh, there we go. Right. You'll need to climb up as well, Sen. Build yourself a little stack and climb on up. So if I put down some more here, we're going to carry on and just keep doing this same thing over and on every single layer. And then tomorrow, when we come back to it, this will be like all finished then. That'll be it. So make sure you leave a gap above us, Sen, because that's where we're going to need to climb up to the next layer.
Okay.
So I'm going to run down through with the repeaters down here like this. There's another one. Two more there. Here we go. Right, this is starting to look really good. And it's really easy to build as well. It's, the only thing is, that it is really is time consuming. It's actually really, really easy to make this thing. Some farms are actually really complicated and quite difficult to set up and so on. But this is just really simple. So you got your sticky pistons, and that's probably the hardest part, is getting your sticky pistons, because you need a farm of some sort to be able to get the slime balls. That's probably the most expensive part, is the slime balls, because they do, once you've got your slime farm, then you can make an enderman farm, and then we should have thousands of enderpearls, and we'll be able to start playing Minecraft Golf. I think that's going to be brilliant. So let's just quickly, I'm just going to quickly throw down these pressure plates down here, and then we'll say goodbye, and we'll carry on and finish this, and then tomorrow we can go through, remove all the torches and stuff like that, and it's gone all dark here. I'm going to just drink one more potion in a minute. There we go. Yeah, tomorrow we'll work our way down through, removing all the torches that we've put up, and the stairs and that on the outside. That's all got to go. And yeah, hopefully then we'll start getting a whole load of Endermen turning up. Is that everything in this layer? Oh no, we need a bit more endstone down here. There we go. Right, that's everything in here. Have you left a gap? Oh yeah, there we go. Right. Oops. Yeah. Just stand on one of the pressure plates a minute, then. Let's test it. Whoa, whoa, yeah, careful. Don't stand on the pressure plate behind this block. It will push you into the block and make bad things happen. If I put a couple torches up, then we can go up onto the next layer. There we go. We don't want anything spawning in here just yet. Where's my endstone? There we go. There. Right. Okay, so anyway, yeah. Thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar and Senlea, the Ender Farm Builders. Goodbye, and see you later.
Bye.